Hello everyone, this is Crota giving you Game 3 in a best of 3 series between Polt, Prime, and I Am Luzra here on Shakura's Plateau. Game 1 going to I Am Luzra, who was able to fend off a very early aggressive bunker harassment with double racks Marines. Polt Prime responding with a similar strategy, this time not using, or last time not using the bunker as much as just trying to hide a barracks. And then having a very nice timing push where the Marines were able to enter inside the base without being spotted and scouted out by Zerglings. We now see I Am Luzra spawning here at the top left-hand side of Shakura's Plateau as the blue Zerg. Meanwhile, back here we have Polt Prime spawning as the red Terran player. We are going to have a drone now make its way out, and we'll see whether Polt Prime sticks to that double barrack strategy, or if he tries to go for the more standard barracks into refinery. Both options are very viable against a Zerg player, as Zerg players need to spend a lot of resources on into getting an early hatchery for more mineral production and more larvae. Overlord now making its way over here. Not 100% sure why the Overlord and the drone are scouting the same position, but yes, the drone now coming in, and perhaps we'll be able to get some damage onto that one particular SCV over here as a refinery now coming into play. So yes, it is going to be a different game this time around, perhaps changing the game up because it is Shakura's Plateau, and now a drone just being forced to wander around continually. We are going to be getting the Overlord positioning itself right here. Orbital Command should be upgraded in just a moment as the barracks is now nearing completion. Most likely two additional SCVs here. And now that drone, perhaps playing a little bit of a mind game, and now Polt Prime most likely is going to try to scout out this location first, just because he sees the drone inside of his base as opposed to the Overlord. Now taking a look at this SCV now making its way out. The Overlord is in this position. As long as the Overlord stops moving just as that SCV comes into play, the SCV may not figure it out. No, SCV is still going to check if it is on the north side first. Perhaps he did get a sight of this one particular Overlord as a Marine, I believe, was trying to get some damage onto this drone. There it is. The Marine may be able to get off that final shot, and yes, there it goes. So down goes that drone. Hatchery has been placed down, and now SCV just wandering around on the inside of that base. The spawning pool not yet completed. Extractor is already up, and it's going to be quite some time before we are going to have any large number of Marines inside the base. Based upon the positioning of Polt Prime, if he could build a reactor here and then go for double Hellions. Double Hellions are an effective strategy. He should probably also try to get a second Geyser, as he likes to go into Banshee play, and based upon the previous matchups, so Banshee play is one of his tried and true strategies. Even though the Zerg player has always responded well with Mutilus, we are going to be getting a command center and a factory at the and the factory going to be double training Hellions in just a moment, perhaps already lifted off and trying to wait for that there command center being built there, and now trying to play that switcheroo in order to double train those Hellions. Hellions doubly trained, twice as effective, obviously, as they're going to be able to get a lot of damage. But a spine crawler on the ramp has another thing or two to say about that early aggression. Zerglings now running across the map here. We are going to be getting those double Hellions, and now also getting a tech lab as well. I do not see a starport, so Polt Prime still has a number of different options that he can try to transition into. There are two Hellions now up, already ready to go, and those Hellions are going to be able to outmaneuver those Zerglings as those Hellions move faster than unupgraded Zerglings. Now trying to get as much damage, trying to clean up all of these early Zerglings already, and it looks like another line of attack there. The loss is already starting to mount up. 150 resources lost, 6 Zerglings lost in this battle. But one of the reasons why Shakura's Plateau is such a good map for Zerg players, there is a ramp leading to your natural expansion, so the Queen with that spine crawler getting a decent amount of site information. We are getting, what, 4 Hellions now, trying to test that front door. The Hellions now making sure that there isn't an expansion over here before trying to put pressure onto that main location. There are a lot of Overlords just sporadically placed across the map, and now we are going into more racks play, so the Hellions perhaps going to try to test the waters, see how much damage they can do. I do not see a starport anytime soon, so it's not going to be an elevator drop onto the high ground there, as the Overlord, I believe, able to see those Hellions And perhaps those Hellions want to try to make a run for it, do a drive-by, but a range of 7, just enough to cover that front door there. The Hellions getting some damage onto that one queen, and the damage is starting to rack up there as a command center has been placed down. So, based upon the production now, it looks like we are going to be having the stimmed marines with a lot of stimmed marines to be, in fact, as the Zerglings now making their way out. Hellions going to be able to torch that Zergling very easily. And now, with no set of backdoor rocks, it is not very easy for a Terran player to really bust down and break into a Zerg style of play. We are seeing a Mutalisk come into play, though, and this is going to be an issue. If he does go into a lot of Mutalisks, he may think that that's probably the best strategy, but that is not the best strategy at this time. With this many reactors, he's able to train up, I believe, on average, one barracks with the reactor trains 5 marines a minute, so this is 15-16 marines a minute. That is going to be a large number of marines very, very quickly. And with only Mutalisk to counter, Scanner Sweep most likely revealing that spire, he has to be pretty happy. We are going to get that Stimpak, Siege Tank, and Missile Turrets most likely underway as well, as we just finished this Engineering Bay here, and the units are in full retreat. Siege Tank doesn't have Siege Tech just quite yet, the Siege Tank, and now Banelings being added. So Banelings are going to be added to this group, and it's going to be a game to see who can do the most damage with the more efficient army. Polt Prime currently behind in SCV count, but larger in army count by a significant amount. Production, though, showing 6 food of Zerglings and 12 food of Mutalisks being added. So 1,200, about 1,800 resources or 1,600 resources all of a sudden in there. We do need to see more Overlord production as Luzra currently supply locked. That is not something you want to see from a Zerg player, especially as they're able to get or train up a lot of Overlords at a time. Now training up 3 or 2 Overlords there, and now needing to add more and more Mutalisks. He is running off a 4 gas play, so he should be able to train up about 5 to 6 Mutalisks a minute. Mutalisks now looking for a target. Not really going to be able to... Oh, finding the Hellions instead, and the Hellions now need to run away. Going to clean up that other Zergling there. Down it goes, as the Mutalisks now looking to see how much damage it can do. There is one missile turret straight in the mineral line, and that is the perfect position on that missile turret, as that missile turret is within combat range of those Mutalisks that try to unspread just outside of combat range there. And now you can see that refinery is going to get destroyed. Perhaps the auto-tracking... would have been a perfect research there to try to get some damage, and because it's right straight in that mineral line, SCVs are able to easily repair it. Zerglings now going to perhaps try to do a flank here. The siege tanks may get caught out of position. Yeah, a lot of siege tanks may get caught out of position. Combat shield about to be completed, and now this is going to be looking very, very good for Polt if he's able to get a lot of damage production-wise. 12 Zerglings, though. So those Zerglings on that ramp, this is going to be very, very crucial to see how much damage these siege tanks can get. Scanner Sweep revealing a lot of spine crawlers. The siege tanks perhaps should have sieged up just a bit earlier and before trying to blast their way through. And now one queen now destroyed. That is going to be an issue. A second queen, and now the damage is coming in. Mutalisks trying to swarm in along that backside, able to take down one of the siege tanks as the Hellions and Marauders trying to start walking up that ramp there. Damage is being dealt, and the spine crawlers are going to get destroyed. The Banelings having a very difficult time as they need to make their way down the ramp. The Mutalisks cannot find another easy target at all as the siege tanks are just waylaying this place location here. Banelings getting detonated by those siege tanks. Nicely done, as those Mutalisks now trying to swarm in and finish off the rest of those Marines, but the Marines with a decent range of 5 able to finish off more there. Zerglings now trying to swarm in as well. Zerglings now coming back from the far side. Banelings now going to try to position themselves, and that is going to be a problem there, but the Banelings going after the siege tank, and now the Marines are splitting up, and now the losses, and both sides losing a majority of their army, but the Zerg, 5,700 resources lost compared to 3,000. That is a significant difference, as the Terran still has enough of an army to perhaps push once more. Overlords, Zerglings need to morph into Banelings. Once again, that is going to be an issue, as the Marines, with medevac support now, going to be able to push up that ramp in a very easy manner. Siege tanks now coming over as well. Marines now coming back in to reinforce. Level 1 weapons upgrade. And as Luzra does not have enough another hatchery, his production is not going to be able to keep up with the Terran, who has so many reactors. You can see four Raxes there, and now more units just playing defense as the Marines are going to be coming in. Marines now coming in from that backside. There are more Marines pushing in over here. The Banelings now trying to come in as well, but the Siege Tanks are going to be able to blast away once more. That Siege Tank getting off a couple quick kills. Another Queen going to get destroyed as those Marines now trying to pull away. Marines are splitting up, and beautifully done there. A very, very strong Marine split, making sure that those Banelings are not able to find their targets nearly as well. Once again, splitting those Marines, and that is just beautiful for a Terran player. Marines now fighting against a sea of drones. Marines once again backing off. We are getting another round of reinforcements coming in as the Marines playing a game of chicken. And it looks like Polt Prime, in such a dominating fashion with these units, getting a lot of damage. One Baneling over here. More Banelings going to be trying to roll on in. And that Siege Tank saving those Marines. Marines saving Siege Tanks. Siege Tanks saving Marines. And doing such a great job as the Marines are just continuing to file in. And I believe the GG has to be coming in. There's not much that I Am Luzra can do. And there it is. So Polt Prime taking game three in this best of three series, coming back from a 1-0 deficit. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. I hope you guys enjoyed this best of three matchup between Polt Prime and I Am Luzra here on Shakura's Plateau.